Hi everyone, and welcome to Medical Cases Explained, Super Easy Antibiotics, MSSA versus MRSA. Staphylococci are the main bacterial villains. As a doctor, you kind of have to know how to treat them. In order to give the right antibiotics, you have to understand one crucial thing. You've probably heard of MRSA, but what the hell is it? There are two different strains of Staphylococcus aureus. The easy-to-treat one, MSSA or methicillin, susceptible Staphylococcus aureus, and the really difficult-to-treat one called MRSA, methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. But what makes them so different? They have a different wall. Betalactams insert themselves into the bacterial wall and destroy it, therefore destroying the bacteria. But they need a very specific protein called penicillin-binding protein to do so. MRSA doesn't have this protein in its wall, so betalactams cannot attach themselves. No attachment, no effect. Sort of like when your ex changed the lock to their apartment. Your key doesn't work anymore, so you cannot enter the flat. How to know if your patient has MSSA or MRSA? Easy. You need the antibiogram. There are always two steps you need to take. One, check which bacteria grows in the sample. Two, check if it is oxacillin susceptible. Penicillin? No. Ampicillin? No. It needs to be oxacillin. If it is oxacillin susceptible, then you have MSSA. And if it is oxacillin resistant, then you have MRSA. So which antibiotic would be your first choice intravenously? For MSSA, that is oxacillin susceptible Staphylococcus aureus. You give fluoxacillin. I told you it's easy to treat. But MRSA is the little devil. Because it changed its wall, the betalactams don't work. There are only two intravenous antibiotics you can give, daptomycin and vancomycin. That's it. To recap, the change in one single protein in the bacterial wall made easy to treat MSSA into a MRSA monster. Want to learn more? Join our Facebook community. Link in the description.